Verse 6. I have set watchmen upon thy walls. I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace, day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence. Isaiah was instructed, perhaps, under the guidance of the Lord, and God was the one who was the author of it. But watchmen were set upon Israel's walls. Walls were places of protection. And these watchmen did not simply peer into the dark, did not come back to you merely to report what was wrong or right. But these were God's men, watchmen, set upon the walls. And what does it say? I have set upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, watchmen which shall never hold their peace, day nor night. And this answers to the spirit of intercession. It answers to the spirit of dedication. It is the cry that does not cease, not day nor night. It shall be a people who shall cry something unto God. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence, and give God no rest. And give God no rest. Don't stop praying. Don't stop petitioning. Don't stop fasting. Don't stop believing. Don't stop declaring. Don't stop prophesying. Give God no rest till he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth. Don't give God any rest. Be there when he is come to the door in the morning. Be there at night. Don't stop your prayers or petitions, but bring them before God day and night without ceasing. Your people are going to be a praise in the earth. Your people are going to be touched by the Spirit of God. Demon powers and demon spirits are going to flee away. Sickness shall not continue, but my spirit shall rise in the midst of thee, saith the Lord, and I shall bring forth my blessing. Yea, I shall open the fountains again, saith the Lord God Almighty, and you shall taste indeed that the Lord is good, and you shall laugh because his joy shall flow into you, and out of his power shall flow a river that shall touch thee and bless thee, saith the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. I have set watchmen upon the walls. And those watchmen are meant to reach toward heaven. They're meant to reach toward God. They're meant to stir God. They're meant to let God know we have a need for something and we haven't forgotten. We've got a promise and we haven't forgotten. We've got a power and we haven't forgotten. We have an inheritance and we haven't forgotten. We've got a name and we haven't forgotten. We've got a joy and we haven't forgotten. Our God shall come and shall not keep silence, but he shall perform what he has promised. Come, Lord, into our midst. Come, Lord, into our hearts. Come, Lord, into our spirits. Cause the power of hell to flee, and touch us, my God, with a new touch of thy grace. Hallelujah. I have set watchmen upon thy walls. I have set watchmen upon your walls, O Jerusalem. Your walls, discouraged ones. Your walls, sick ones. Your walls, heartbroken. God has put somebody upon your walls, and you might think you're all alone, but when God's will is done, there's somebody that's sitting on your wall, and they're getting a hold of God for you, and you shall not die but live and give God the glory. Hallelujah. I've set watchmen upon thy walls, O thou weak saint. Thou walls, O thou cast down ones, upon your walls, you that are disappointed, upon your walls, you that find it hard to serve God, upon your walls, you that sit and watch soap operas, you upon your walls, you that are playing the lottery, upon your walls, God has set watchmen, and he has decreed that he shall hear those watchmen who give God no rest until God brings transformation and change to people who name the name of Jesus. Well, say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What would Israel be without Isaiah? Without what was stirring in him? God's people have a place. God has called us for a reason. God has called the deep and the dedicated for a work to do. He's called you, first of all, to have a vision. For where there is no vision, the people perish. But there is a vision. God's people shall know his power. And we find that the will of God is to bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. That's why I like to preach the gospel. When I start, sometimes I see a catastrophe out there. You're coming in like you came out of the jungle somewhere, swinging in on a vine. Stupid feelings and carnal attitudes and laziness and every kind of thing that's wrong. But I'll get you before the service is over, and I'll turn your mind toward Jesus. I'll bring you into his presence. I'll tell you that he's alive. I'll get you excited about Jesus before it's over. Some services, when it begins, I'm almost afraid. It's almost sacrilege, the attitude that some people have toward the things of God. The minds are carnal to the core. And I cry, oh God, give me some time. Give me some time. Because I'm going to preach until these people are turned toward thee. Give me some time. I'm going to bring them to a place where they'll forsake ungodliness and worldly lust. Give me some time. I'll breathe upon them your spirit. Give me some time, and I'll bring your glory into their lives. Well, hallelujah. I've set watchmen upon your walls. Oh, these are special men. They never close, but they turn their ministry over to another when they leave. But the ministry goes on day and night. I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace. There's a consistency if you're going to get something from God. It goes beyond the human ability. It's spirit. And when the body's not able to go on, somebody else has to pick it up, but it has to go on. It can't cease. Prayer can't cease. Faith can't cease. The word of God can't cease. It's got to go on, not just Sunday to Sunday, but there's got to be a river that's picked up by the power of God that never ends. Hallelujah. I set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace, day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. Keep not silence, and give him no rest. Give him no rest. Turn not away from your vision. Participate in your desire. Give him no rest till he make Jerusalem a praise in the earth. A praise in the earth. How can you get a hold of God tonight and saying, God, I don't want to be a poor excuse for a believer. I want to know him and the power of his resurrection. I want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. And I want the ministry of impartation, that when I touch somebody else, they're changed by the power of God. The Apostle Paul in the New Testament, he had that ministry. Paul spoke and said one time, everyone has turned away from me. They're all seeking their own. Everyone has forsaken me. But one didn't forsake Paul. People weren't much different that day than they are today. But Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the Bible teaches, and God wrought special miracles by the hands of the Apostle Paul. that from his body were taken handkerchiefs and aprons and laid upon the tormented and the sick, and demon spirits left those that were tormented, and the sick were healed by the power of God, because there was a river inside of this man, Paul. And when he went to a place where no Christian had ever been before, a church was planted because it was God's spirit in his life. Stand with me in this service. Where there is no vision, the people perish. Christianity is not a haven. It's a testimony of an empty tomb. Christianity is not a refuge. It is a challenge. That our God has come, and he will not keep silent. It is a healing, delivering, life-giving spirit. Where the spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. And God wants a witness in the earth. He wants a witness in the earth. He wants a witness in your paycheck. He wants a witness in your checkbook. He wants a witness in your body. He wants a witness in your mind. He wants a witness in your spirit. He wants a witness in your song. He wants a witness in your house. He wants a witness in this assembly. He wants praise brought to his name. He's a God of life and power. Isaiah said, I won't be silent. I won't cease. I won't take rest. I refuse to. I'll stir you and impart until his spirit flows into you, and until God's people in God's city is a praise in the earth. I trust God gives you a vision. God's people are meant to be a praise in the earth. God does it through prophecy. Thus saith the Lord. In the last days, saith God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. I bring you to the altar at this end of the service.